shit to 2006.
Hey, yo, I'ma start it off first.
I inspired Direct from Grind Time to start up his shit.
Oh, dude, I party like a rock star.
Then came King of the Dot, URL, and all the other leagues in this bitch.
I am King of the Dot. My name's embedded in that shit. A legendary status you will never establish. I put in classic after classic, 10 years in a row.
I'm a legend, dog. Demigod on a whole nother echelon.
Such an aura, an icon, that the limelight always shines on.
So what does battle rap in general mean to you?
That was a gay ass question, bro. Man, being on this card is really important to me. At first, I was like, man, I should do a documentary about Pat, or I should host a pay-per-view. It's like, no, I should battle.
Former King of the Dot champion, battler to my left, introduce yourself.
Rony Baby the Prince, I will always be the prince. Make some noise for the real king, Pat Stay.
To be honest, I haven't battled in years. I think over 5 years was my last battle. And just to be on this card with the people that love Pat Stay and also just happen to be some of the best battle rappers in the world, like, I feel honored that I'm thrown into that conversation.
Battler to my right, introduce yourself.
Dumbfound out of K-Town, Los Angeles, baby.
So for an event like this, it was really me just kind of angling for someone that I respected so much, just so we can kind of have the as good of a clash as possible. It's really me being selfish, being like, wow, he's just about as good as it gets from my perspective, so I'd love to go against him.
It didn't even feel like a call out. It felt more like an invite, like, let's do this together for Pat.
I got the scouting report on Dumb. And I can make it go left, no sweat. I'll turn this shit into a Game of Thrones set. Grotesque, we go bet, I'm taking his whole check. Funny how I'm 3 bars in and I still haven't cracked an Asian joke yet.
The king has returned to the Dot. Korean Jesus is home. All these lazy rappers using Asian accents, finally they leave me alone.
I want to let Dumbfounded know that I know about him, okay? I've spent time with you in Los Angeles, Cafe Blue. I've had long nights with you, and I've seen what you do. And I'm talking about bullying whites. I know you bully white people with your gang of Korean-American rappers. I know that you guys bully whites, okay? I know you lure them into your trap, and you call them pale-faced, round-eyed fork pushers. And I know that it's some crazy slurs that you're coming up with just for the whites, and I see you, okay, buddy? Don't try that shit.
King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is, Toronto! Make some noise for Pat Stay, yo! All the way from Koreatown, Los Angeles, battler to my right, introduce yourself!
Dumbfound out of K-Town, Los Angeles, baby!
All the way from the mean streets of Philly, former King of the Dot champion, battler to my left, introduce yourself!
Rony Baby the Prince, I will always be the prince. Make some noise for the real king, Pat Stay.
One king.
Dumb fan who won a coin toss, he chose Rome to go first. Toronto, Energy check, make some motherfucking noise, y'all. Let's get it.
You. I got the scouting report on Dumb, and I can make it go left. No sweat. I'll turn this shit into a Game of Thrones set. Grotesque. We go bet. I'm taking his whole check. Funny how I'm 3 bars in and I still haven't cracked an Asian joke yet. I'm the greatest of all time. Most creative of all time. Check the history. I cross T's and dot the small I's. No racist shit. No racist shit. Those narrow views are not mine. Like a North Korean nuke, boy, that shit will not fly. His real name is John Park. And you were off to a hot start. But then you named yourself Dumb. That makes me think you're not smart. You listen to his music, you think his vibe was all dark, but he's got the personality of a greeter at Walmart. Well, it's going down. It's going down. Like a Bella Danger in the elevator. Fuck an intercom in a generator. I'll put the Yellow Ranger on a ventilator. The original. A Ranger on a ventilator. The original king. I'm Cedric the Entertainer with the pen and paper. I educate your casuals. I'm John Madden through the telestrator. You're a pencil pusher with a calculator. A now and later to an alligator. I'm a Hall of Famer, bitch. You watch the Lakers. If I need a favor, then I call the Lakers. Or the Bulls. Or the Bulls.
My
last battle, I wore Dion's. Within a year, I was bros with him. I name dropped Pat Bev. Within 2, I had a show with him. Manifesting, I got the future in my hands and I'm molding it. If I had name dropped Jesus Christ, he probably would have rose again. What? I'm at the podium, barking like a Doberman. Some kung fu put Bong Joon-ho through the linoleum. You had free Anderson Paak beats, and you still couldn't blow with them. Now he's a MSG, and this pussy's throwing sodium. Well, I hear all the chirps from these seedy suckers, but I pretend I don't see it like I'm Stevie Wonder. We're opposites. There's no way that we could see each other. You're Asian. Bitch, I'm getting even younger. But growing up, I bet there's painful memories you can't jog. Like going to the rub and tug to get a hand job and it's your grandma. Ah! And that's a hell of a quandary when you have your dick out. Do you dismount? Do you ask for the family discount? See, it's crazy. It's crazy, right? Crazy. Yo, you're not descended from Kublai Khan. You're a waiter at Budokan. So pay attention whose Louboutins you've been spilling those noodles on. It's the rap game Sarat. It's the rap game Sarat. The way that I paint with dots. Find me dumping a machine gun like Megan Fox. We could box. We could box. Find me dumping a... Bro. What? What? I said it's the rap game Sarat. The way that I paint with dots. Find me dumping a machine gun like Megan Fox. We could box. Find him slumped out down at a vacant lot. You can't tell, is he slumped out or is he doing the Asian squat? On Twitter, November 9th, 2018. You said if I ever go broke, I'll hop back in that ring. Well, I'm glad that you're here, but I'm sorry you're back. Welcome home, Dumb. Let me know if you need to borrow some cash.
Take it.
Let's go, Dumb! Let's go, Dumb! Everyone, it's on Dumbfounder. Let's go!
Check. Can I get this up a little louder? I feel like that's a little louder. There you go. Yo.
Get me.
You're right, I had a little part in Anderson's future. You hang with Anderson Cooper. By the way, I seen your wife, her body is smoking. When I fuck her, you can watch, I'll leave the door open. Keep up with the references, don't get lost. I'll fuck the wedding ring off of her, call her Silk Sonic the Hedgehog. I said, the king has returned to the dot. Korean Jesus is home. All these lazy rappers using Asian accents, finally they leave me alone.
get it.
Let's go. Oh,
cook me. I came for Pat Stain tonight to celebrate his life. I know two wrongs don't make a right. Maybe killing one wrong can make it right. You really thought you was pushing for with the whole culture. I work for myself. Y'all work for old vultures. It's funny how Lush went to Adam 22, but you're the one with no jumper. Yeah, y'all chauffeurs. Y'all chauffeurs driving Miss Daisies with your bosses in a backseat. I know that y'all can't sleep knowing you exploit black rappers and athletes. Yeah. But at Barstool, you're killing it, bravo. But the only real ones from Philly that I know are Gilly and Wallow. Yeah.
Not real?
I bet you went to the office on the first day. Like, hey, fellas, bang, bang, bird gang. Like, you just...
I knew you had some bird gangs.
I said, I bet you went to the office on the first lay. Like, hey, fellas, bang, bang, bird gang. Like, you just learned slang. Yeah, get it through your nerd brain. You're lame. Your only black friend is Pat Bev. And on that show, you won't even let Pat talk. How your roots in Philly, but what, you won't even listen to a black thought.
Cook me.
Yo. You must have lost your marbles, they're insane. Give me the green light, I'll slap the shit out of them and hit a lick on a cracker like Squid Game.
It's crazy.
Come on.
Respect him.
Come on. I said, you must have lost your marbles or insane. Give me the green light, I'll slap the shit out of him and hit a lick on a cracker like Squid Game. I'll call his bluff, like Parasite sneaking his crazy rich parents' house when they've gone to brunch. Shang-Chi, 10 rings, I break everything everywhere all at once.
Oscar
who the fuck saying, ah, fuck y'all.
Respect him.
I'm sick of your tired puns. They've already been all done. There's only so many ways you can be called dumb, but I don't gotta use name flips to call you a bitch because you already are one.
So? So what?
You're an enormous geek with your Old Navy performance fleece. What is that, Mormon chic? I hate dorks that can't play sports but wear official game shorts. But you chose to stand on the sidelines. That was a good call. Look, y'all, the only dude to get injured in fantasy football. You know how I know you're a loser, though? Two words, Super Bowl.
That's fucked up. That was fucked up. That's beyond...
Y'all lost to the Chiefs. I know that shit Jalen Hurts. It was damn near reparation seeing the natives take it first. To make it worse, Jalen's ankle worked. This guy came to work with a Philly championship tee because he pre-made the shirt. You damn near lose to every Patrick that you know. So do us all a favor and take your ass Mahomes.
So good.
Round two, it's on roll. Let's go. King of the Dot.
Bro, you have the tiniest set of nostrils. I can't tell if it's cool, if it's lame. On one hand, you stay ducking diseases. On the other, you do love cocaine. And I'm not judging. It's just the way his face was designed. But if you're gonna share drugs, plan on taking your time. Cause when everybody else is out breaking out lines, he's gotta snort his cocaine one grain at a time. He breathes in, it sounds like a long range missile. He breathes out, it sounds like a fucking train whistle. They tried to rape this dude, it would have been a terrible day. He just exhaled hard and it scared him away. Fucking square ass head, brother. Who are you? The offspring of Lucy Liu and a Rubik's Cube? Who is your uncle, Ock? A fucking Funko Pop? My boy's a... I said, who is your uncle, Ock? A fucking Funko Pop? My boy's a Lego, best believe he runs a couple blocks. And I'm not even hating, bro. I like that, looking like a fine-ass character from Minecraft. But it's getting hard to tell what kind of accent he's flexing. You got a weird twang like a Cantonese Texan. I'll leave you crying in H-Mart like Japanese breakfast. I got the smoke like fajitas in your Applebee's section. I'll split his dumpling once that 50 peel. Bow, you just got yourself a Disney deal. My bro's mad, I'm popping up in his bitch be real. She throw it back like a homer at a Wrigley Field. I'll give her 15 bucks and she'll lick these nuts. Your girl's a hoe by name and your mom's kimchi sucks. I said, that hurts. I know that hurts. Gross. Over-fermented. I said, dumb must be dumb if he's thinking he's at the top. You might think he's fish scale. From how I see it, it has to stop. You might think that he's raw. From how I see it, that shit's chalk. You might see dumb as a brick. I see dumb as a bag of rocks. And doom is doom is imminent, bitch. You could see the shark tail. You try to drag race me, I'll put your Civic through a guardrail. Dumb's dumb as a hammer. You would buy it at a yard sale. I'll put this battle in a coffin and use dumb as a doornail. But wait. He said his 10-year goal was to star in an action movie. That's a doozy. You're 5'6" and a half with boobies. The closest you ever get to an action movie is if they remake Cars and you voice a hatchback Suzuki. The closest he'll ever get to an action movie is if they remake Cars and you voice a hatchback Suzuki. Or in Mickey Mouse as a Mandarin Goofy. Or in VeggieTales as the sushi. Let's go through a checklist for an action hero. Athleticism, that's a zero. Acting chops aren't half De Niro. Sex appeal is Dan DeVito. Stop it, Chino. The closest you ever get to an action hero is getting a Frappuccino for Al Pacino. Bro. And it's not because you're Asian, they just don't like sucking. 20 indie movies in and now you wanna try stunting? Indie 50, Indie 60, you might realize something. Keep playing that race card, you might hit Indie 500. Bro, on Twitter, November 9th, 2018, you said, if I ever go broke, I'll hop back in that ring. Well, I already gave you a 20. That's just me being decent. So pay me back when you get that action flick. Matter of fact, keep it.
Yeah. Round two, it's on Dumb. Let's go. King of the Dot.
Yo.
When we were yelling Black Lives Matter, trying to stop Asian hate, you were storming the Capitol trying to keep Caucasians safe.
It worked.
In Ferguson, you thought the cops saved the day. With Breonna Taylor, you would not say her name. You were mad as shit at Kaepernick, you little sports boy. You won't take one knee for George Floyd, but I bet you take two knees for Dave Portnoy.
Sports boy.
You little sports boy.
Yeah.
Yo. I just know your mom's a Karen. They call her Carone. All on the phone, naggy tone. Won't even let you rap alone unless she chaperones. She can't condone any rapper with a blacker tone. Den Sharon. You hated Kanye. You wouldn't even slap his songs till he appeared on Alex Jones. You've been a weirdo. I bet your hero's Ben Shapiro. And he hates woke bitches. I can't make that up. Nah, I mean like he hates woke bitches. Like he likes the ones that can't get up off a date rape drug. I'm not saying you're a racist person. I'm just saying he dressed up as Meek Mill and got the makeup perfect. You know, Trudeau. Yeah. His favorite movie's Rocky III, but he won't be caught dead watching Creed. But he'll rewatch the scene where Apollo dies in a boxing ring. It's funny how when a black man got the lead, he's like, not for me. tripping about the Little Mermaid. Imagine that scenario. A grown man mad about Ariel. When they considered Idris Elba for James Bond, he was like, God damn it, the whole thing's wrong. Bro, that's weird. You got so much black fear, you won't even watch Black Mirror. I asked him if he saw Get Out. He said, nope. The great white hope with a face like the Pope. You see, you're not really helping the people when you don't see no one else but yourself as an equal. That's why you'll never get the ring. You're a Philadelphia Schmeagle.
Round three, it's on Sharon. I'm wrong, my bad. That's my first fuck-up.
What?
Hey, he's better than next. It's all good.
That was so mean.
That's my bad, man, because I know they up next.
Wait, this isn't Sharon? But
what the hell? Only Pat can do it. So he's right. As a cis white male, I... As a cis white male, I acknowledge that my existence is inherently racist. I've read the books, I've done the work, and I can finally face it. And it's not racist like I think one side has better genetics, but like, I don't think you have a black fan that doesn't have a tentacle fetish. Now, is that wrong? Yes. It's bigoted and selfish. But since all white people are inherently racist, I guess I can't help it. No. Even though it's been underground, I still look like a fucking clown. And it's been wrong, because as the majority, I was punching down, and I felt bad. Was I part of this massive machine, cutting off a culture before they could advance and succeed? So I took chances to read all the fantastic cuisine, all the history. I damn near traced it back to Adam and Eve, and on a global scale, all the demographics are deep. 6 out of 10 of all people come from back in the East. So if 3 out of 5 are Asian, that mathematically means that the real minority here is... actually me. And I'm feeling marginalized. I need some acknowledgement. This feeling's hard to describe. I might need a scholarship. This shit is tough to ignore and not to run up the score, but since I'm not punching down, then my Asian jokes aren't fucked up anymore. So you know what rhymes with Fu Manchu? Wuhan flu. All your faces look the same like the Blue Man Group. I know COVID fucked up your diet. You could barely eat it all. Cause when you heard it was made in a lab, you were thinking the breed of dog. You'll turn a PetSmart to a Wet Mart so aggressively. And your cultural specialty was adding kimchi to the COVID recipe. Wait. I say that for a reason. In a movie called Bad Rap, you gave battle rap a bad rap. Right after it made you famous, it got stabbed in the damn back. You claimed the premise was racist. Like you didn't advance that? Like we're not just roasting? Someone get him a Tampax. You've had Mexican jokes, Arab jokes, like that shit was usual. You versus an Asian guy was like the stereotype Super Bowl. You told a black guy they served fried chicken at his funeral, and the worst part is, I thought that shit was beautiful. But it's his reasoning that puts my mind into a pretzel. He said, tiger mom's good at math. All these stereotypes are stressful. They keep calling me a doctor. It's a bit disrespectful. I might quit battle rap if they keep calling me rich and successful. And it's the most benign insults. They said rice eater, it's the worst. Oh, they said you eat the most popular food on earth? See, every chopstick joke isn't a hate crime. We're different. That's cool. It's not a story for Dateline. And that's why I'm not concerned with playing dumb online, because you never know when the man above calls time. Hey, Pat, look what we did in your name.
Look what we did in your name. We miss you every day, bro. Shit isn't the same. I wish that you were here to help us through the scariness. And because SoulCon is by now, it's hilarious. Bro, I wish I could just call you. We could roast the shit for weeks. Bi-ass Jew doing circumcisions with his teeth. And so until the day that we could call him gay together, we got your fam, we'll hold your flame. Pat, stay forever.
Final round, let's go.
Yes, sir. Check, check. I went from booze binge to juice cleanse. I'm feeling like a new man. I know it makes you sick like I flew in from Wuhan to get the W like a Wu fan. No chance. I came out of AA meeting ready to throw hands and stomp you with my sponsor. Now that's a 12-step program. For the last 2 weeks I fasted. I've got the sober life mastered. Close my eyes, frozen time, know the fly, catch it. It's like Bruce Lee, flow like water, ocean tide. This is Beats Me, season 4 or 5 of Cobra Kai. You see, a few years ago, I took him to LA. I was his tour guide. And boy, you never seen nobody more white. That shit felt like training day. It was Denzel and an incel. He thought we was in the jungles. I was like, bro, this is Glendale. You know it don't end well when you're at the karaoke singing Thug Mansion wearing Oakleys. You would have sworn we were at a Lollapalooza. He was bowing at everybody and shit. Homie, we are not the Yakuza. I said, fuck it, let's get some drugs. We did some bumps. He started mixing pixie dust in bitches' Dixie cups. We needed a little pick-me-up. He literally had to pick her up. That shit was sus. Y'all really think I'ma get dissed by this bitch? Who is this, mid-twist? You're 33 and have been pledging a fraternity for eternity. Before journalism, you were journaling. You're now an anchorman, Ron Burgundy. I just wanna slap that snapback hat off, bro. Looking like a whack backpack frat Jack Harlow. I know for the past few months you were on your computer like, write me a battle rap, ChatGPT. Revise that, make it more like a frat smack DVD. Good, now change it into the cadence of my favorite rapper. Great, now give me a list of famous Asian actors. Neat. Neat. Now take this bar and change it backwards and put a bunch of bullshit in the middle, same as disaster. Sweet. Now ask it about me. My jersey hangs in the rafters. Your status is questionable. Maybe AI ain't the answer.
Crazy. Crazy.
You see, matter of fact, I peeped your plan of attack since you were on Twitter telling everybody I was your fantasy match. Bro, I don't give a fuck about you. I came back to battle for Pat. That's why I got Pat on the front. You just wanted a Pat on the back. Make some noise, Serrano.
Make some noise for Dumbfounded and Road, y'all.
Thank you, bro.
You're a legend, bro. That was
dude, battle rap is like this magical place where like unicorns come through these cotton candy clouds with rainbows just jizzing out of their dick. I love it here.
Man, I'll tell you right now, the energy is always crazy. I feel like the last three battles, I left so much time in between that I forget what the energy's like up there. And it's just like nothing else, man. And this was a beautiful thing. Everyone is like here showing love, you know. It was great. I always love hearing a fresh take on an Asian joke, you know.
Battle rap put me in a level of comfortability where no matter what stage I'm on, it's never as hard as battle rap. You know what I mean? Like if I'm fucking singing at a concert or like fucking presenting to a bunch of investors, like that shit is easier than battle rap. So like now that I've done the hardest thing, I know it doesn't really like get harder as far as a performance standpoint. I think that this is the toughest type of performance to do, but now you just know like where the ceiling is and it's just like, okay, that's how hard it gets. Like I've done this before and I can just, I can make it work. And Dumbfounded is the same way. Like he's a performer, he has a podcast, he's doing stand up all the time, he's getting on stage, he's like, you know, controlling a crowd like it's his job, and it is his job, and he's really good at it.
It's interesting because we both take in, you know, we've both taken our careers to a bunch of different places. So we technically have a lot of shit to, a lot of material to go off of, but they're really accolades, you know what I'm saying? Like we've done well. It's not like we've done bad. So I think that part, just figuring out an angle, you know, like that's all about angles, man. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I think like I felt like I chose the right angles. You know what I'm saying? Like I really love the angles that I chose.
To be honest, I feel like it's getting easier with age. And maybe it's because there's enough space in between everything where I don't have this pressure on myself. But it doesn't I'm not nervous the same way that I was. Like the concepts come to me more clearly. Like I kind of just see it, and there's less wasted space, like less wasted motion. I used to write three times as much as I would need and only pick the best from that. And now like I'm not leaving out that much stuff. It's like the stuff that's in like deserves to be in, and the writing process has gotten tighter.
They eventually got it, but shit took a long time for certain lines. Like that finally they leave me alone with the Asian accent. Like they should have gotten that. Yeah, but they took a little bit. You know what I'm saying? They were like, oh! You know?
Bro, I said, I know COVID fucked up your diet. You could barely eat at all. Because when you heard it was made in a lab, you were thinking the breed of dog. I thought that one kind of, it was too much in there. Yeah. It was too layered. But like the, you know, lab, it was a little bit too much, but I still enjoy that joke for myself. I ran that by like a couple of like big stand-up comedians, and they thought it was funny. So I was like, these guys think it's funny. The fucking battle rap audience will love it. They didn't, but so that one was for me.
I don't know. I'm very proud of all the shit that I came with, you know? And I think with Rome, man, I feel like, of course, there's Asian jokes, but I use Asian jokes against Asian dude too. But I always enjoy like a fresh rhyme scheme or a certain take on it. And I definitely heard like new shit that I was like, okay, that's some new shit. You know what I'm saying? And I always acknowledge and show some love for some new shit.
What up, suckers? Just a cat, you'll be here. Past Babe. AKA Sucker Free Bonk. Get me John's lunch, give me 445. You ready for this? Hell no, I got you covered. Fucking Gary, 29 years old. Past Dave raps off the mastermind. Exaggerated shit, but Patrick saves the shit. I don't want to battle no more. I just want to relax.
Shuts down my dead homies. Suckers! I'm just joking. See ya!